In this example, we calculate equilibrium concentrations from the equilibrium constant and initial concentrations, solving for X using two simplifying assumptions. Our problem reads, if a reaction vessel initially contains 0.60 atmospheres of carbon dioxide and 0.80 atmospheres of carbon tetrafluoride, what is the equilibrium pressure of carbonyl difluoride? We can begin by creating a rice table with a reaction at the top and the initial pressures in the second row. We are not told we have any carbonyl difluoride gas to begin with, so its initial pressure is zero. To determine the change in pressure, we need to calculate the reaction quotient to determine which direction the reaction will shift to reach equilibrium. When calculating the reaction quotient Q, we use the Kp expression, but we substitute in the current pressures. Since we don't have any reactant to begin with, we have zero in the denominator, and our reaction quotient is infinity. The reaction quotient is larger than the equilibrium constant, so we need to shift left to reach equilibrium. This means we will have plus 2x, minus x, and minus x for our change row. The coefficients 2, 1, and 1 come from the coefficients in the balanced chemical equation. The equilibrium row is the initial row plus the change row. Now we need to solve for x using the equilibrium constant expression. The value of Kp was given in the problem, and we can plug in the equilibrium row of the rice table for the pressures. Although we could use the quadratic formula to solve for x, we can notice that our value of Kp is very, very large. This means we will have very little reactant at equilibrium compared to product. 2x represents the amount of reactant we will have at equilibrium. Since this value must be very small, x is very small. If x is very small, then 0.60 minus x should be about equal to 0.60, and 0.80 minus x should be about equal to 0.80. These are our two simplifying assumptions. If we plug these simplifying assumptions into our Kp expression, we will be able to solve for x without using the quadratic formula. First, we can square 2x, which is in parentheses, so both the 2 and the x are squared, to get 4x squared. We can multiply both sides of the equation by x squared. Next, we can divide both sides of the equation by 3.0 times 10 to the 6th and take the square root of both sides, which is the same as raising both sides to the power of 1/2. Completing this calculation, we should get 2.0 times 10 to the negative 4 for x. Next, we can plug the value of x back into our equilibrium row to solve for the pressure of carbonyl fluoride gas. We should get 4.0 times 10 to the negative 4 atmospheres, which should be our answer to this problem. To check that we solve for x correctly, we can plug the equilibrium row back into our equilibrium constant expression, substituting in the value of x that we calculated based on our simplifying assumptions. Completing this calculation, we should get 3.0 times 10 to the 6. Since this is our original value of Kp, we've solved for x correctly. We can also check our two assumptions using the 5% rule. According to the 5% rule, if we divide what we removed from the expression by the original expression and multiply by 100%, we should get a number less than 5%. Our assumption was that 0.60 minus x was about equal to 0.60. So we removed x from the expression. This goes in the numerator. Our original expression was 0.60 minus x. This goes in the denominator. If we substitute in the value of x we calculated based on our assumptions, we should get an error of 0.033%. This is far below 5%, so this assumption should be valid. We can check the second assumption in a similar manner. We assumed 0.80 minus x was equal to 0.80, so we removed x from the expression. X goes into the numerator again, and 0.80 minus x goes in the denominator. This simplifying assumption has an error of 0.025%, which is also far below 5%. This assumption is also valid.